up, guys, and welcome to this episode today. Welcome back. Now, I'm actually going to be talking about magic. I might even do a couple of tricks for you. Alright. This is mainly about close-up magic and what I do. Right. I do close-up magic because it's just so much funner and you get a lot better reaction out of people. They're so surprised with what you show them. They're like, whoa. Like, one of my most recent tricks I've learned is a coin trick, alright? I've got no sleeves or nothing, you guys can see that. So I'll just grab a coin. Simple. Get it, that is not it. Alright, coin tricks are one of my favourites because people just, they get really confused when they see it and they're like, ah, I know how you did it. And they go, bah, you done this, you done that, and then you prove them wrong, it's so much better. So you take the coin, you know, I'll show you, I've got the coin up here. You take it and all I need to do is this. And it's gone. But you will realise if you're going to do that trick, once you do the trick, people always seem to say, oh, you've got it in your other hand. That's the first place they look, is your other hand. Alright, they don't keep an eye on this hand. They watch this hand, right? But it's not, because when I obviously do this and it's gone, there's no trace of it at all. So people get really confused after, when they think you've got it in that hand, and then when you show them that you bring the other hand into play as well, and you do it, they're like, and especially pulling cards out of thin air as well. That's relatively fun to do, because a lot of people get confused by that as well. You just kind of pull cards like that. People, like, they always think, whoa, like, they just don't know how it's done, and they wonder. One rule of being a magician, never do your trick twice. Once is the trick, twice is the lesson. Alright, that's what you learn. Once you do the trick, second time is pretty much you're teaching them how to do it. Alright, it is simple. That's what I say, once is a trick, twice is a lesson. Alright. What other tricks have I learned recently? Okay, so this is one of the tricks I've learned recently. These cards are fake. They're double-sided. They're double-backed cards, alright? As you can see, look. Some of these cards, most of them are all fake. They're all double-backed cards, so I'm going to take one. Don't get rid of these ones. I'm going to print onto this an actual card. Right, get me? I'll put it here. Cool. Nah, nothing. There we go, that one. See, just these card tricks work a lot better sometimes if you don't use cards, if that makes sense. If you use something different. The way Michael Ammer, he taught people how to do this with business cards. It is great, it's a wonderful trick, it's just so perfect and out there, and it's just great. You know, things, you see people do tricks and stuff and they're just, wow, you get really confused by them. One of my most favourite close-up magic tricks is the card-changing magic trick. Alright, my hands are really slimy. I had to put cream in one, guys, you're not going to be bad. The card-changing one, so you just give the normal card, alright? Pinch it between these two fingers. Right, you can tell people it's just a play card. You just give it a wee flick. And it changes. Alright, simple enough. And then people get really confused. And you can also tell them, they always go, turn the card round. And you just go, right, okay. Just a card. Just one card. And then they get really confused. Because they don't know what's happened. Close-up magic. It is so funny to do. My favourite one to do, I think, is this one. If you just keep an eye on this card, guys, and watch where I put it, alright? I'm going to take it, shove it in here, and you snap, pop straight back to the top again. Take this card, alright, and shove it somewhere in here, up in the middle, roughly. Right, that's one of my favourite ones. As you can see, it's roughly in the middle there. How many cards would you say that's down? About 20 cards or so. Something like that, yeah. So I'm just going to take these cards, I'm going to take the bottom half of the deck. There we go, bottom half a deck, push that card in again. Take your card, put it in halfway in that deck there, put this deck halfway in here. Give it a wee snap, and we flick, and it pops straight back to the top again. Right, so we take it, push this card up, take this deck out. Usually if I was a spectator here, I'd give this half to a spectator to keep in between their hands so I can't get to it, but for the purposes of the video, I'll put it in my mouth. But I can't talk now. Alright, so I take the card here, I put it in your deck, and I snap, and I hit. Oh, okay. Ah. There we go. People always like, people know magic is just sleight of hand, deception, illusion. It's just so certain ways you do tricks. Obviously, I teach tricks as well, right? So, this trick involves a quite popular move called the double lift. If you guys know what the double lift is, I might do a video on how to do that at one point. So, yeah. Cards and use double lifts and what's the different ones? This one's a really good one. This one's called, I've showed you this, guys, this trick before. It's one of my favourites. It does require a little bit of a setup, though. So bear with me. Shuffle it. Just ask them. Shuffle it as many times as you want. But you need to make sure you do the shuffle properly. Otherwise, it's not going to work. Because the two cards you want to force on them are these two. Alright. Make sure the two cards are matching. For example, King of Diamonds, King of Hearts. As long as the two cards are red, and the two cards have the exact same number, you're fine. You're sorted. Alright. There we go. It'll be three of spades, three of clubs. Three of hearts, three of diamonds. Or seven of hearts, seven of clubs. That's seven of diamonds, sorry. Clubs. Boo. And these two cards go on top. So when you're shuffling it, you need to force them to stay at the top. If you get this. Alright. Now what I do here, shuffle through the deck. Now, you guys know, obviously know a mechanics grip. Alright. But this one, grip like this. I honestly have no idea what this grip's called. I can't remember. Gorilla grip, we'll call it, for the time being. Alright. And you fruffle through like that, the deck, and you just, when they say stop, you stop. So when they say stop, take the top deck off and say that's your card. Okay, give them the card. And you can give it another wee shuffle if you want to, just to make it more believable. Pretty much giving you a teacher a lesson here on how to do magic as well. And you do the exact same thing again. So what I'm actually doing, when you shuffle through it and they say stop, pull the card and you give them the top card off that deck. Alright. What I'm actually doing is, this card here, right, King of Clubs, we're going to force that on them. So when you hold it with these three fingers pushed against that, quite tight, so you can maybe get a wee bend, or use your thumb knuckle. Once you've got to that point, like this, alright, what you're doing, you're pulling these cards off here, taking them all out, but using these three fingers to clamp this one and keep it there, and it folds down. But the faster you do it, it doesn't look like you're doing anything. Look, I'll do it quite fast, so it's a five, alright, on top, so you shuffle and you go, right, okay, there you go. That is that card there. Simple. And obviously, the two cards I picked off earlier, they're going to be matching, alright. I'm really glad they were matching there, because that would have been really embarrassing if I'd done that and they weren't matching. yeah. So guys, yeah. We talk about magic and just how things are going to happen. I'm still going to do magic on my channel and all as well, because I love it. I was actually watching Dynamo do some tricks last night on YouTube, and I was watching just saying, I know how you do that, man. I know how that's done. See, because I know all the moves and stuff now, and all that's like hand and stuff. I just know how most of it's done. It's not right. Yeah, it's weird. But yeah, it's cool. It's good to know this stuff. So guys, thanks for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, leave a thumbs up on the video. If you want to see more magic videos, leave a thumbs up on it. I don't care, I'm putting more out there anyway. Be awesome. You guys are great. Thanks for watching. You deserve all the love in the world. You all deserve positive smiles. So you do. I love you all. I just want to give you all a big hug. I love you guys. Thanks for watching. Leave a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. I'll see you in the next video. Goodbye. Give me a hug, guys. I love you guys.